There we go. Okay. So, last couple weeks, this isn't complete. We were going to complete our drawing and get in on the side. We started out with toning the canvas, did our rule of thirds grid. We did a little thumbnail sketch with a value study. Then we started sketching in and putting in the three values of white, gray, and black. We already had gray, so it was maybe a darker shade of gray and the white. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of our student works here, and we're going to make some adjustments to it so that you can see, you know, how to make those subtle corrections that'll make a difference before you start glazing on color. So, okay for you, George. Yeah. All right. Yes. Your reference and all that. Figure out what we need to do here. Thanks. I'll just take that and I'll put it right here.
Full picture.
Okay. All right. Well, we're going to be working from the black and white right now.
Mm-hmm.
So color. So let's take, you know what, let me put this over here. Because I got to have it this way because I'm left-handed and I don't like water on your painting. Okay, thanks. All right, so great. Oh, so it looks like we have a great start here. We can make some adjustments to the drawing and to the values. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and, because we're using just a neutral black and white palette here. So I want to make sure that I have like a medium gray at least. Maybe darker because medium gray is the color of the canvas and we don't really need that. Now I may have to put some things back. I'll just mix a color that's similar to that, or a value that's similar to that, and put that in. So I'm just going to start here. Okay. All right. So first things first, we'll put some corrections. I want to have a paper towel handy. I'm going to make some corrections to the drawing, and through this, you'll see how you can correct your drawing. Oh, hold on. Let me put this this way, so that you can see that better. All right, let's see. I'll zoom in a little. That might be too much. Let's see. No, that's pretty good. All right, let's move this over because we don't need to see all that palette. Yes, go ahead, sit down. Thanks. You want to take a chair? You want to get a? You could take pull a chair up. See what's going on. Okay. How to correct it. Okay. All right. So the first thing I want to do is I want to check my angles, right? So I see if I approximate that, then I know that that's a little. But I see here that this line here is in the correct direction. So that's how I do that. Yeah. All right. So not much to fit here. Yeah. So I'm just going to take some of this gray. And I'm just going to modify this to what maybe it resembles more in the picture. I'm going to come back here. All right, so I kind of fixed that, mm-hmm. and then there's, you know, not much to really fix. So I have that, and then this comes down, and then it kind of comes down like this, right? Kind of almost going maybe even blind contour here. All right, so that's probably okay. That's closer to what, mm-hmm. what we need. Let's see if I can take that down a bit. There we go. Okay. All right, now the sand is lighter. So it's not quite, well, it's probably the lightest. It's probably like a tint. Exactly. We'll leave that for now. Okay, so this looks pretty good over here. Let me just take a little bit
out.
Just a little bit out over here. See, and you can see it yourself, right? Now that you get it. See, all right, so it comes in a little bit over here, then there's a little bit there, and then there's a little bit there, and then it comes down here, and then into that, and then it comes around like this, right? So you're not really far off.
Not far off.
Not far off at all.
With the gray.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I would say, okay, so a little bit darker gray here, right? A little bit darker gray, and I can take and put this top in. Make that. So I'll make this correction to those values. And that's a little bit darker. Darker over here. This, I'm gonna darken that up a little bit, come out like that. Okay, so I'm making some adjustments. Well, the color glaze on top of it. It either gets glazed or you can make it opaque. The key is once you have all the values established, whatever color you mix, if you put a dot of it in that area, if you squint, if that color disappears into the gray value, then you know that it's the right value.
Yeah.
If you squint, yeah. Huh. So that's the value of doing the grayscale first, even if it's just in general, because it does help you get your colors the correct value, because you have that there to compare it to.
Mm-hmm.
If you're going blindly without the color, it's a little bit more difficult.
Mm-hmm.
I find that it's just a bit easier to be able to separate that. So I see here there's a lot of dark, there's a lot of contrast here, but you notice that it's not too high contrast. So what I would say is just to make those lines a lighter value.
Mm-hmm.
Because when I compare here to here, it's the difference between dark and light is a little bit too much. So that's what I mean by, you know, like comparing these different areas. And what you can do too is, you know, you can even do it by, since we did the rule of thirds grid, you can compare it even within a square just mm-hmm. to help you visualize it better. Like I would say here in the back, like it's pretty dark around that line, but you know, you can kind of just rough in. Let me just take this square for example. I can rough that in, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then I can take, I know that the sky is a bit lighter in some areas. It's lighter than that. So I can take some of this, and I can lighten that a bit.
But with the gray, I'm not doing it with
color. With the gray, pulling out the major, just the major shade of gray. And
there's a lighter line.
There's a lighter line over here. Just for reference. And it kind of continues out here, kind of fades out. So let me just get some. I'll just get a damp brush, and I'm just gonna try to
pull it down.
Yeah, not like blend it. Not that you have to have blends, because
it's more watercolor than I imagined.
Yeah, well, you do have a lot of soft transitions in this
mm-hmm.
particular scene. And now here, you see, actually, the sand is even lighter, right? It's even lighter than what's up here. So if I compare the light up here to
mm-hmm.
the light right
mm-hmm.
there, see how much lighter
water.
Oh, you know what?
That's what I think it is.
It could be. To me, it looks like sand, but
yeah.
I can argue that. I mean, not argue, but, you know, you can it could be an interpretation. Yeah. All right, so you got that sand line there. You know it's lighter than that light that we
mm-hmm.
made, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I could just make really quick, since I'm already in comparison mode, I can go here and just kind of scumble some of that in, or just in general, just plop it in, because, oh yeah. And then there's some negative space in between here, right? There's that shape, you can plop that shape in, and you can plop in and see how some of those shapes are, you can plop those in. So now, I'm not saying you don't necessarily have to do all the little divots, you can add those later when you do add color to it, but it's good now to just make a reference to the fact that, okay, yeah,
mm-hmm.
You could just make a reference to the fact, you know, just be sketchy with it, just to give the impression, firm that up later. But at least you know approximately what value it is. And it kind of continues over here, right? And even and in between these branches, not quite as light though. Most of your lights are towards the waterline.
Mm-hmm.
And then it gets slightly darker as you move down. So we have this, and then right under here, you see there's this little shape in there, right?
It's like a heart.
Yeah. Yeah. So you can actually even think of it that way. You can tell yourself that it looks like that, you know, and that is, those types of things can be very helpful when we're putting it in. Oh, and see, that's a little bit lighter. That's lighter in there. And there's a little bit of light in there. So you see what I'm saying? So now it's starting to come out. So we, all right, so let's do, give me an example of lightening some of those darks up.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And also maybe grouping some of these. Let's see. So over here, it looks like I have, if I could define that, it comes in like this, kind of goes down this way. And in some places it might be actually lighter, but I'm seeing this, you know, connecting that mm-hmm. together. See? And that's coming out. And then it might be a little bit, it starts to get a little bit darker there, so I take a little bit of black and mix that in there. And then I'm going to place another section next to it that's a bit darker. There we go. And then I plop that in. And actually, with my brush stroke even, I could probably go ahead and suggest, you know, some of the textures. And, you know, I'm going to leave that there because I see that there, mm-hmm. right? It's, you can see some of that, so we'll leave that in there. Right? And say, right over here, there's a bit of there. I'm going to take some black. I'm just going to make, we have this here, right? There's a little bit more dark in there. And then up here, just a little fleck of dark, and we can take just what's on my brush and just kind of stumble that, just to tone that down, bring this, pull back down whatever paint's there, and that's going to help. And, okay, so we got a brighter spot here, right there. A little bit here, and then we have some strokes here. So, you know, we're starting to make the adjustments to our values. Mm-hmm. And if you look at it, even on the screen, you can mm-hmm. see that it's, you know, starting to come together a little bit more. Like, and I would say here, like, this is more of a grouping,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Like, I would generalize that more. Let's see. That's a little bit too dark, too light. So here, let's put this. Come down here, and put that there. Put that here, even though I do see something that's a little bit darker, and it kind of wraps around there. And there's a little bit of black that's coming up here. So I can fleck that up. There's like a little triangle shape. So I'm looking at the shapes. It's always about the shapes and the angles. And here, there's a little bit of dark there, a little bit of dark here. But there's also some more light. late. Yes, yep. Yeah, right here. Kind of comes like that. And then it kind of comes over. And then it kind of comes down. Right? And then, oh, and then this comes, that comes that way, just like you have it. And then it comes down like that. So it's basically value. We're mapping values. And just with, you know, basically brush strokes. That's it. Even here, I can, let's generalize that too. We can generalize this by coming down here. There's a V there, right? But, right, so here we actually kind of emphasize that, right? By coming down like that. We can always put a little bit back if we took away too much. But, there we go. And, you know, there's a lot of, you know,
descriptive stuff
here. Yeah. Let's figure that out. Oh, okay. So we have this, it's coming out from underneath, right? And then it's coming down like this, and then down like that, like that. But then it gets darker as it recedes, right? Underneath here. That in. So we're gonna have to make some adjustments, but well, everything that's underneath here is on the dark side. So, like in, right under here, so we have this here, that there, that there. There's a lot of stuff, but it's fun because, you know, it. I think it's fun. I think it's fun to figure out all these little intricacies. And not that you have to, you don't have to have it all perfect. It, just as long as you get the feeling of that, you know, this wonderful tree and using the brush up, almost like it could almost be Van Gogh-like in a lot of ways. You know, the way, all of these different, lines and the way the branches to that trunk and have all of these, like, forms, like stringy forms there, kind of string together, so that's cool. And then we have that under there, and you have this coming over here, right? Something coming over there, and then kind of continues a little bit over here, and there's a bunch of different
things.
Yeah, things.
There's the thing.
Yep. Right. Just like, and you had those. So I pulled that through. So I think, you know, that all start to come through. So I would say, out here we have maybe something a little bit darker in that section, right?
The grays. I'm not doing the
still do the grays, establish that, because you have these different values.
Yeah.
Even, you know, you have that, that's a little bit dark. So we can, you know, go ahead, like the shadow underneath where it meets, but then it's probably a bit lighter there.
Well, that one there is really dark.
Right. But now even that's showing up okay. And then this land mass over here has a value, right? So, you know, this is probably about right. And that'll define, that different value will define that. But then we see here. Yeah, it's got it over here, right? You can go back into it, but. All right. And then again, you know, you have.
Mm-hmm.
And it does kind of dry darker.
It drops darker.
Yeah, so that's something I gotta keep in mind here. All right. So I don't mean to take over, but okay. But okay. So this is how, you know, an example. Mapping out values. Yeah.
So keep on mapping.
Keep on mapping. You can take it if you want.
I'll take it.
He already got stuff. All right. Okay. So who else needs help with mapping, value mapping, getting in your Grisai?
Yeah, Tom.
Okay. Anyway. And we'll just go ahead and... Grisai.
Oh, Grisai.
Grayscale in French.
Oh, okay.
That's what a Gris... Yeah. That's what Grisai means. It's just a... It doesn't necessarily have to be gray. It's just another way to say a monochromatic. It's okay. Okay. Oh, put any color in it. Oh, what happened? I thought this was going to be yours.
No. I moved it over.
Oh. No? I don't know. Because now it looks like it's not the same angle. Okay, so... All right, yeah, let's get your picture. Because I'm going to show you really quick something.
I used another color in this picture. Let me see what that was about.
Okay. All right, so let's take the picture over here. This over here. And, all right, I don't have any colors. Thing, but.
Want me to get those colors?
Well, I got a brush. Just give me some. Yeah. Okay, so here we have the classic. This is one of the classic challenges, okay? Okay. Okay. The challenge is always with doing, you know, things that are tall and skinny or anything that's. You know, that has verticals, is that, you know.
There has to be some
symmetry there. Look at this.
Right. I'm looking at that, and I'm still saying that this was the better angle. Or it could have been, or maybe even here. Not really, because, well, here. All right, let's test the theory. Hold on. All right. Let me just use this. Hold on. All right. Let's just take a little bit of this black paint. All right. Okay. So let's just say. All right.
If this is the center of the object, right?
It ends here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then it has to also, from that point on, so it can't be.
The original line was better
from that perspective, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Let's put that back.
I didn't put it back, right?
But I can do that like this. Or with.
Somewhere.
I could just use this. This will help us see it better too. Because then I can blank out what's in the back. Okay, so here. There we go. So I used the paper. See, now that looks more like in the realm of reality. What's throwing you off is that there's a shadow there.
Yeah.
So it gives the impression that it might be a little bit too skinny.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's take this. Let's draw through the center.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
so that's a,
that's good there. There to there. This is going to give me better line. Okay, I think we straightened that out. All right. So we can flare that out a little bit more there. Okay, so
now when I do over this line,
let's take a little bit of light. We're actually going to lay that out. Because I'm going to take whatever black is on here. Add some gray to that edge. Blend some white into it. So there. Even though it doesn't really. And it's going to be a little bit, I'm going to add a little bit of gray to that side too, just to show. Yeah, clean brush. Get a little black over there. Going to layer more. I'm just going to Yeah. And actually, you're not going to use dark white out of the tube.
No?
Nope, because the light that you want is, it's going to have some warmth to it, right? Some light has some warmth to it, so you straight light out of the tube.
So how do I make it warm?
Well, the warmth that you can use, sometimes you can use a little yellow ochre, combination of the yellow ochre and maybe a little bit of cad red light you can use. Okay. It depends on what color you see in the picture.
Okay. With what?
Yeah, it's yellow. You're going to mix it a touch of it in with the white.
Oh, with the white.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be mainly white, but it needs to be tinted so that it shows some warmth.
Mm-hmm. That's on the light. No one annoying, which is.
So it's kind of like more sepia tone. So we have the raw umber. I'm going to mix a little bit of that in. But so I can correct the rest of your lighthouse and you can see it better.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think that, this is kind of
throwing
you off.
You're right.
It's throwing you off. Are about reevaluating portions and checking what you've done.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what I'd say is So overall, that the lighthouse itself is going to be, that's supposed to read red. It's actually going to be, let's do the sepia. I'm gonna make it darker.
Now can you do red?
Not right now. I just want you to be able to see it
right now.
Okay. So we're just gonna plop those in. Okay, so this is like an upside down frown a little bit. If I had to look at what that angle was.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'm just gonna one shade.
Mm-hmm.
Now I can make it a little bit lighter on the other side. But I'm gonna start with this, right? To up the value because the shadow on that side is about that color. And then we have the light that's on the other side. Right? And this is going to look more like, it's gonna end up looking more like the values of the photo. Going to be darker than the sky, so the sky's going to have to be a little bit lighter. But anyway, you get the idea.
The sky will not be that blue for me.
It'll be blue. Sure. Well, it's like, it's sepia tone. It looks like an old photograph.
Mm-hmm.
Like burnt umber with black. That, if you're going to make painting that sepia tone, that's the color combination that you use.
What did you say that?
Sepia tone. You know, like an old photo, like an old photograph that was like real. It appeared like really, really dark brown instead
mm-hmm.
of black.
Mm-hmm.
That's what sepia tone is.
Yeah.
And you know, on your phone, if you want to see what sepia tone looks like on a photograph, there usually is a sepia filter. Pick that, and then you'll see what any photograph that you have would look like if it were sepia tone.
Mm-hmm.
So that sky is going to have to be a little bit lighter. Next to that. So we do that, and then we really have made our corrections here.
Mm-hmm.
And really, there are no lines. The reason why we perceive lines are just where two different values or colors meet. It's that part. A line is a human construct. It's not a, it doesn't really exist. Okay.
Well, this is a mess.
Well, no, I think that is good. I think that here, for example, it's just a matter of, okay, so you have the dark. You might want to put, you know what, I'm just going to map this out right here where, okay, so you might have to make it a little bit more ragged, maybe, right? And then maybe bring it up that up some. And then from what I see here is this, it's kind of like a, gray. All right, so that reads as kind of a black, and then you have like some of this gray here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm just gonna add really sketchy. Right. And then here, what do you have? You have
yeah,
and it's just
white.
Mm-hmm. You know, getting closer to.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. So, yeah, so. Be lighter, that's all. So, you know, you're playing the comparison. What are the shapes that the different
values
make? Here, it might get a little
like
darker.
These colors. Instead of the red and the blue.
Yeah. You know, it's different. You know, we don't normally, you know, in the the typical lighthouse picture.
Yeah.
You know, those are the things that you normally see, but that doesn't mean you have to.
Really?
You know,
do whatever you want.
you know, play it up as much as you want. But, all right, so. So we can just keep that loose. I mean, it looks like your lighthouse is, it's a little bit closer. I'm using the side of my brush, you know.
Mm-hmm.
See through this, you can see what. Also, get a closer look at what, you know, how to use the brush, you know, with the brushwork. Like, you don't have to be so like that. You could scumble things in and because that's nice. It looks a lot more natural,
yeah,
see,
it does.
Than if
you get those.
And by having, see, I like the way that's dark or darker right there, because that what high contrast areas is where your eye goes first. So that keeps that along with that.
What do I do in the background?
Well, you would pretty much use the same colors. I would say you're going to use white, the raw umber or burnt umber, and black. And you could do this whole thing sepia tone.
What color would you?
It's going to be close to what this is. With some more like areas, if you want to add more interest in the sky, like clouds and things. So, if you don't like this particular sky and you want to see, like, maybe some wispy cloud,
yeah.
I'm not saying, like, a real cloudy day.
Yeah.
You can always use another reference photo that has clouds in it that you would like to put in your painting, mm-hmm. and you can use it.
Okay. Well, yeah. You like this
long. Yeah.
Then I'm not sure about what I would do with this whole background.
Can't do this.
We could work on the palette.
White in there? What would that be?
What's going to be on?
What I would say is that it is green. So what I would do is, you want to put in your darkest dark. Black and whatever is not white, that would be white.
Okay.
Think about that first. Anything that is white and that leads in gray, you want to plot, make some notes there. And remember, with it, when it comes to okay, you can always add the sky holes later.
Right.
You can keep this wall as one shape and generalize first. Make it flat. And yeah, you can make it kind of flat with the ragged edges. You can treat them as different.
Okay.
All right. Yeah. Yep. And the same is basically, I see some value mapping in here. Like, you can stumble in the different values that you see, even though we're in any single color. Like that would be really flat. Windows are really flat. Windows are really flat. Just like these. You'll put the window panes in later. Our shutters will be a gray. The windows themselves are going to be a black. The right side of the chimney is a black.
Okay.
You can use to do black, use ultramarine blue and Yes. so I can get my screen ready. Walking through York, wherever you see York, and even maybe you're around that dinosaur, walk to the side here. I don't know how much detail you plan on going in, but even in there, I would say make notes as to where the blacks are, put in the blacks. Blacks, dark rings. What I did here is that maybe too much texture. I would say blend it out a little bit. Water. Is it still wet? Yeah, use a damp brush and just soak it up a little bit for now. You don't have to do that in detail. Go ahead. I actually did a painting over COVID, or I started a painting but didn't finish it. That was sepia tone. It wasn't abstract though. Okay, so I have burnt umber here, black, and I have white. So basically all you need. This is a reminder. Okay. I'm gonna get over here and make this closer so you can see this better. There we go. All right. So I have burnt umber and I have black. So I want about half of my color is going to be burnt umber, half is black. I'm going to mix them together, right? And this is going to give me, you know, that nice, warm, really, really dark brown that reads as the black. Okay. All right. Okay. On either. What I need after that point is I need to make different values. Okay. So I'm going to put white at one end here. Okay. All right. And then I'm going to take some white in the middle. I'm going to try to get them in between, right?
in between. I might have to make it a little bit darker. And you could just make different values. Now, if you feel like it's brown and you want it to be more black and more grayed out, then you can add more black, you know, to your mixture. Okay. But here, white, I'm going to mix the in-between for these two, right? Get some more white in there. So that's actually really light. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save that because that's closer to the white, right? So I'll move the white over, and I'm going to move this over since it's like a tint, and then I can get yet another value in between there. That's from here to here. So I'll take a little bit of that, a bit of this. So now I have in between value. Actually, it needs a little bit more white to make it a little bit more different. There we go. That's better. Now it's more in between. So I'm just eyeballing that. Just so that you have some values to start with. I mean, obviously, there's going to be even more gradations when you're doing, you know, your full-fledged, you know, refined, with tone painting there. Because, you know, we started out very general with the mapping. And this will give you more of a range so that you can create finer blends and transitions. So here, let me move this over. And then I can get a couple of steps in there. Let's see. You know, sepia tone, it can be one of those really beautiful. Makes a beautiful painting, it really does, if you decide to go that route. You don't always have to go full color. Depends on the subject. I think it has a beautiful vintage feel. You know, that you would see in an old photograph. Put a little bit more light in there. Get that in between. So now we have that. A little bit darker, but here, let's move this over. And so you can get a full range of different stuff. Huh? Okay. Yep. So I had white, I have, you know, burnt sienna, not burnt sienna, burnt and ivory black, and then these are just a range of values. So, yep. And it can be, you know, a really great, and you could still use black if you want to and put the, you know, black in. But this pretty much means close to black. Well, what I would do is I would look at my reference and I would see which one of these values the sky was closest to and use that.
The sky was closest to in what?
In value. In the bottom white picture.
In the
black and white picture, pick the value that's closest. Let's see your picture again. We can do that now.
That's it. Index card. I'm getting an index card.
Hold on, let me zoom out. Zoom out. Okay, so I have this palette mixed. And where's your photo? Okay, so we have the photo.
And I split which one is the closest to. It's somewhere in between these two, right?
So I'll take the lighter one because I think I'll dry lighter anyway. So let's take a look. See how that comes out. Got my bigger brush here. Let's see. Does it look? Looks like it might be too light. Let's take this. Yeah, there we go.
Oh, yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Isn't that cool? Pretty color.
Because it brings it out, too.
Yeah. Dark and... Right. Yep. And this gives you just what you need. Yep. Now, you could also, to add more interest in this guy, you could always add, you know, sort of street more darker colors and lighter colors into it.
Like what?
Cloud? Yeah, to make it look like a cloud. Some white, yeah, while it's still wet. And then after that, go back in to put even more light. But what I would say in general, the sky should be darker at the top and lighter at the bottom. So if I make this darker, right, say I make this dark. By the time I get to the bottom, let's see, I want to make sure that, you know, I mix something light, lighter, so that there's a difference. Because, you know, that gives you more of a feeling of atmosphere. Now, I need to put, we need to put thicker paint on here, but at least, you know, right here.
Why would you know to put lighter stuff at the bottom?
Because when you look out this window, there's just the way nature is. If you look towards the horizon line, you see, even if you look up there at the blue in the sky, now look down, you see how it gets layered? That's atmospheric perspective at play. So you definitely want to make it, you know, you make it darker. Darker at the top, and I'm kind of using like a crisscross type of brush stroke for now. Now, this doesn't mean I can go back in after I have this base on and add more details.
Right.
But right now, I'm just trying to show you, just in general, if you want a feeling of atmosphere and a sky, this is the way to get it.
Okay.
Just really simply by doing it darker at the top and lighter. I don't know if you do. All right, so I did it on that side.
Yeah.
So that means that, all right, so we'll have to, you know, continue that. But that would make a beautiful sepia tone. It's going to be great. And I think that, you know, you can take this and use it.
Okay.
To mix more, there's more right there.
Do
you need a bigger brush?
I got a big brush.
All right. Okay. And here's your picture.
We got that.
All right. So, let's take a look and see. I know I have the best students, so I'm lucky there. I know that. Oh, you know what? I'm going to go around. Let me just check my live stream. That's still in good condition. Awesome. All right. Maybe next time when we meet, I'll have actually to work on my grisaille so that next time when we meet, you know, we'll be ready to go with, you know, a little color demo. Aren't you?
But no, it's not.
That's all right. Well, you know, we still got to think about our values. Yeah, but you know what? It's the most important thing. Just focus on the three. You don't have to get real, real detailed. And you don't have to put every detail in the picture either. Like, for example, window panes. You don't have to do individual window panes when you're putting in a grisaille. You just want to map out where the lights, the darks, and the grays are. That's it. And what shapes they make. That's all we're after. Let's see. I'm going to bring not sure why my All right. I'm just going to have to go back to this while I'm walking around.
amazing.
Wow.
Yeah.
So I was
this room is called the Church of the Red Doors.
Where?
The That was a good part, you know, how it's in the red and and I was thinking, yeah, so I was thinking of keeping the gray tones, but the gray and the green, and the gray and the brown, and then make these more red. And so I think this is something called, but these are, you know, right. These are, you know,
because those colors
are gray, and they're not really red. So that's kind of what I wanted to do. Because
right, if you're
and stone and
exactly, you have to paint it the way you feel connected to it, you know, in a way that you can. That's not, the point is not to, you know, completely do a full Renaissance and paint it at all, if that's not what you're doing. However, that perspective and the perspective, the lines and the shapes that you have. Really great to combine those beautiful shapes with this idea of how this seems
to be really good. It's very good.
It's a wow factor.
It's very social.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. your
I'm going to end this.